and two details. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi was handed on Wednesday the Arab Developmental Action Shield 2020 by Arab League Secretary General Ahmed Abul Ghait. This came during President al-Sisi's meeting with Abul Ghait in the attendance of Foreign Minister Sameh Shoukry, the Assistant Arab League Secretary, the Assistant Director of the League's Social Affairs Sector, and the Assistant Director of the League's Economic Affairs Sector. The President expressed gratitude for receiving the reward and dedicated the shield for all Egyptians who participated through their awareness in the success of the state's efforts to achieve the economic reform and boost the developmental process. For his part, Abul Ghait praised the comprehensive developmental program led by President el-Sisi in Egypt, which embodies a unique example to be followed in other Arab countries through a sustainable reform in various sectors. The pan-Arab body chief stressed the significance of focusing on the fields that help in raising the living conditions of the citizens, especially development of the infrastructure and the establishment of new urban communities. Presidential spokesman Ambassador Bassam Radi said the annual award is granted to Arab icons who lead the development process in their countries. Radi said the meeting tackled means of fostering the Arab League role during the coming period in developing the joint Arab cooperation to confront challenges the region is currently facing.
President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi met with Prime Minister Mustafa Madbouly and the Minister of Tourism and Antiquities, Khaled Al-Anani, on Wednesday, where he reviewed the ongoing activities and projects as well as incentive packages to support the tourism sector and stabilize the conditions. The President was briefed on the efforts exerted by the Ministry and directed to preserve employment in the tourism sector and stabilize workers' conditions, especially in light of the sector's response to the precautions of the coronavirus pandemic. The head of state instructed to continue efforts to upgrade archaeological sites on a national level within the framework of the state's continuous approach to restore and highlight the Egyptian culture and civilization. In this context, Anani reviewed the ministry's efforts to resume tourism, including rates and facilities, numbers obtaining operation licenses, as well as promotions to most prominent markets exporting tourists to Egypt.
Prime Minister Dr. Mustafa Madbouly hailed on Wednesday efforts exerted by the Health Ministry to confront the spread of the coronavirus pandemic. Madbouly also commended distinguished health service being provided through various presidential initiatives. These came during the Prime Minister's meeting with Minister of Health and Population, Dr. Hela Zaid, who presented him a report over measures carried out to promote health services offered to citizens. Zaid said her ministry worked hard to obtain highest levels of quality for its central laboratories and accreditation for international institutions, adding that the ministry's viruses testing lab had got the ISO for testing COVID-19.
The National Election Authority, NEA, set on 7th of October as a deadline for candidates for the House of Representatives elections to concede contested seats to opposing candidates. The NEA decided that the concessions would be published in any two widely circulated newspapers on the 8th of October. It announced the final list of the candidates after reviewing all ruling issues by the High Administrative Court. The final list includes 4,032 candidates of the uninominal colleges and eight parties in the list system.